Assalamu alaikum and welcome all. I hope that you will be enjoying a happy and healthy life. Today I'm back with another part of Moringa. Today we'll be talking about Moringa propagation and repotting. So I will be repotting this plant and I'll show you other ways of propagating Moringa also, along with the update of last video in which I pruned my Moringa. So this plant is, it seems root bound because its leaves are turning yellow and you can see leaves are smaller than my Moringa plant which I showed you in the first part of this video. So we will repot this plant into two size bigger a pot, and I will be using the soil mix which I told you last time. I have mixed here 70% of the sandy soil of our local area, a handful of perlite, and 30% of kitchen compost. In some other video, I will share with you how to make kitchen compost easily at your home instead of buying some vermicompost or potting mix from the market. I'm using an old pot because it was wider. It will have enough space for the roots to grow. It has big holes in it which I had to cover. So I am going to reuse this old green net. I'll be blocking these holes like this. It will allow the water to go through but not the soil. I will make the base with dry leaves. This will decompose with time and will provide fertilizer to the plant. Now with the same potting soil which we prepared, we will fill the bucket halfway. Is half of the bucket. Okay, now I will remove the plant from that pot and put it here. Let's see how the roots are. You can see the roots. These roots are edible. This plant has a property that its roots, stem, even the leaves, flowers, and fruit, everything is edible. Now after repotting, we will just keep this plant in shade, but it needs regular watering. This plant grows throughout the year. You don't have to worry about when to propagate Moringa. Propagate it in shade or in a little mild climate, not very hot. But in winters, Moringa goes dormant. In fact, it starts shedding its leaf and now let's water our new potted plant. Moringa will become healthy, will produce good green leaves, but will not become a tree in the pot. This step will be like this only. It will not develop into bigger trunk kind of thing because it's not in ground. It will grow nicely, but will not produce fruit in pots. But if you will plant it in ground, it will produce fruit. Now I'm going to remove all the leaves of this plant because the plant comes under stress after repotting. So I'm just going to cut the leaves these leaves I will use in my kitchen. See, I'm cutting it from the nodes where already you can see the sign of sprouting. It will sprout from here. On this stem, it will sprout from here. So I will leave only these two for photosynthesis. And all these leaves can be used in any recipe, omelets. I normally use it in omelets and pasta. Now we can keep it under shade for at least a week, and then I will bring it back to the sunny area of my garden. See, here is that moringa plant which I pruned last time. I have pruned it from here, from this stem, and you can see this new growth. This is the new. This one is the old leaf. This is the new growth. So old leaves were dotted and less green, so I will remove this now. Now this will grow nicely. See, here you can see more growth will come out from here. And see, I pruned this plant from this stem also, and see this one. Then I pruned it from here. Look at this. Look at the new growth. And this is exactly after 8 days, after 1 week. And I will show you one more thing. See this. This is the new growth. These ones. I hope you can see that. All these nodes will sprout now. And one more moringa plant. Here is one more moringa plant. I've moved these plants from that shady area out here in the sunny place. See, I just cut everything from this plant. All the stems I have cut. Now see, it has had three stems, 1, 2, and 3. This one. So now you can see the growth of the plant in 1 week. Not this one. It's also in a pot. It produces nice green leaves. Okay, viewers, for moringa propagation, easy way is from cutting. The other way is from seeds, but seeds will take time to germinate and to grow into a healthier plant. See, this plant which I pruned in last part of the video, this stem was so leggy and it was not stiff. So to support this, I have taken a cutting from my moringa tree and I just put this cutting here to support this stem. When I put this cutting here, there were two reasons. One, to support the stem, and the other one was to get a new moringa plant. You can see the sprout here. Within 1 week, this stem started sprouting. It will become a new plant, and it is supporting my moringa plant also. So there were two reasons to put this stick in it. This is the easy way of propagation. Just remove the thick stem. Stem's thickness should be at least one finger. You can see it's thicker like a finger, and its length will be 12 to 15 inches length would be enough. But I used a little longer to support this stem. So this was all about moringa propagation and repotting. Don't forget to make your moringa happy by daily showering. Hope you like this video. See you next time with another plant in another video. Till then, stay blessed. Allah Hafiz.